Hello student, today I'm going to start chapter 3rd. Topic is liberalization, privatization and globalization from your book Indian Economic Development. Okay, in the first chapter we had learned about what type of economy we gained from Britishers. So we come to know that we are backward and stagnated in every field. Okay, in the second chapter we had learned which type of policy was adopted by the government to improve agriculture sector, to industrial sector, to foreign sector. So for agriculture sector we adopted land reform and green revolution. Okay, and for industrial sector we adopted IPR 1956 and Indian Act 1951. IPR 1956, within that there was threefold classification of industry. Okay, and Industrial Act, it is all about written permission, means licensing system. Okay, and for foreign trade we adopted the policy of import substitution. Import substitution means substituting foreign good with domestic good, means we are going to purchase domestic good in place of foreign goods. Okay, so that is import substitution. Okay, so from 1950 to 1990 we adopted the policy of LPQ, license, permit, quota. Okay, result is that till the 1990 the condition of Indian economy, because of this liberalization, license, permit and quota, okay, we are having foreign currency only for 2 weeks. Yani we cannot purchase oil, other lubricants that is important for running industrial sector, okay, to run machines and equipment in industrial sector. We cannot purchase any capital good from outside. Okay, why? Because we are not having foreign currency and our debt is too much. Okay, inflation is too high in the country, unemployment is also very high in the country. So we require $7 billion for improving the condition, okay, to come out this critical condition. So when we go to World Bank and in International Monetary Fund to get this much amount as a loan, so they have one condition. That condition was that you have to adopt the policy of LPG in place of LPQ. Means you are not going to follow the policy of LPQ. Now you have to follow the policy of LPG. Now what is LPG? Liberalization, privatization and globalization. So here now we are going to discuss about these things. Okay, so first of all, what is the meaning of new economic policy? This is very very important. Okay, so this line, the new economic policy was announced in July 1991. Okay, take this and underline it. Okay, and note down in your copy. It is very important for 1 mark question. When new economic policy was introduced? In July 1991. Okay, now the second line is the meaning of NEP, new economic policy. Okay, when was new economic policy was adopted? So in July 1991. Okay, what is the meaning of NEP? So it consisted of wide range of economic reform. This line is the meaning of new economic policy. Okay, it refers to wide range of economic reform. It refers to what? Wide range of economic reform. So underline, this is the second question. What do you mean by NEP, new economic policy? So this is your answer. It consisted of wide range of economic problem. Yeah, it implies wide range of economic problem. Okay, now what is the aim of new economic policy? So new economic policy, the main aim of new economic policy was to create
a more competitive environment in the economy and to remove barriers entry and growth of the firm. So there are two things is given, okay? So first and very important objective or aim of new economic policy was creating competitive environment. So why we require competitive environment? Okay, whenever there is competitive environment, everyone wants to do the best. Result is that ki you are going to advance, you are going to more modernize. So we are talking about economy, we are talking about Indian economy. So when there will be more competition, there will be more private sector, there will be more entrepreneur, okay, and there will be competition among them to produce goods of good quality at a low price, okay. So for that, this is the first objective. Now next objective is what? To remove barrier to entry and growth of firm, okay. Before the July 1990, there was regulated development of private sector. So regulated development of private sector. We find regulated development of private sector. And how it is regulated? By Industrial Act 1951. What is this? In this, whatever industry were left in Schedule C for private sector, whenever any entrepreneur want to establish any firm, they have to take written permission from the government. If you want to expand your production capacity, you want to launch new unit, again you require written permission. Okay, if you want to diversify, you had to launch first cooler, it is successful. Now you want to produce generator also. So when you want to install the new firm, okay, for the generation of generators, so again you have to take written permission. So because of this written permission, okay, there was controlled development of private sector, because it takes too much time and it takes lot of money as a bribe, it is the basic reason for corruption that time, okay. So before, till July 1991, okay, there was controlled development of private sector. So result is that ki there was too much inflation, okay, our population growth was increasing day by day, and their government is producing goods in a same amount, and private sector, because of this licensing system, they don't want to establish and to do the production, okay. So result is that ki there is too much inflation, okay. So for that, government decided to remove all type of barriers. So foreign investor, foreign company can come in India, they can sell the products, inflation rate will going to be low, and there will be more competition, there will be more production, and new, we are able to we are going to familiar with the new technology, okay. So these are the basic reason for introducing NEP. So I think three questions are prepared. First, what is the meaning, when it was launched, and what was the basic aim, okay. Now, the new economic policy can be broadly classified into two kind of measures. So what are the measures? First, stabilizing measure, okay, and it is very important. Stabilizing measures means what? It is related to those things that is for short term, okay. It is related to measures means steps, policies. So it is related to those policies that is related to short term, okay. And what is aim? First, correcting balance of payment. I had told you now, because of import substitution policy, just we are focusing to producing goods, we don't think about to sell it and to gain foreign currency, okay. So result is that there is too much disbalance in balance of payment is an accounting statement related to export and import of a country. If this is a condition, then our balance of payment is going to be unfavorable. Okay, it's mean what? We are paying too much and we are earning very less. Okay, so to correct this condition, we follow the policy, new economic policy. Second thing is controlling inflation. I had told you now, because of control private development, there was lack of goods and services. Okay, and demand is increasing day by day, but in the same ratio, there is not supply of goods and services. Okay, government sector is not able to do the production in the same proportion. Result is too much inflation, 16.6, more than that, the inflation rate was that time. Okay, so for stabilizing measure is related to all those measures, all those policies that is for correcting balance of payment, and second, controlling inflation. Inflation means what? Increase in price of general goods. Okay, increase in general price levels. Okay, now second is structural reform measure. So structural reform measure is related to long term measures, means that is for long term goals, for achieving long term goals. So what we want to achieve in long term, in a very long period of time, with the help of the NEP. So first we want to achieve improving efficiency of economy. Efficiency means we want our country, our government want that we are able to produce more and more goods and services. So this is related to improving the efficiency, means increase in production of goods and services. Okay, second, structural reform is related to increasing international competition by removing rigidity in various segment of Indian economy. Okay, why we want to do this? When there will be company investors from outside, so there will be flow of money. You know, now India is a developing country. Okay, and in this previous chapter I had told you ki leading role is given to government sector. So one reason is that lack of capital. Capital means what? Money, equipment, machinery, skilled labor. Okay, this is, so in India it is that time it is too much stagnated and backward. So obviously, because of that, we follow the policy ki we had given leading role to government. But till the 1991, okay, its result is that ki their government is not making any change, not making any improvement. They don't want to do any innovation, and private sector, there was too much regulation on them. So when we adopted NEP, our second important objective is that ki there will be international competition. Okay, our firms are able to produce goods that is going to meet or match the standard, international standards. And obviously, we are able to get this objective. Tata, Bata, Khadim, okay, VIP bags, okay, and Maruti, Mahindra, okay, Hero. So these are the companies, they are getting the pride, not within the India, but outside the India. And it is just because of NEP, freedom that is given by the NEP. Okay, so in this way, the new economic policy having two measures. First, a stabilizing measure, within that there are two objectives: correcting balance of payment. Second is controlling inflation. Second measure is structural reform measure. It is related to improving the efficiency, means we are able to produce more goods and services. Second, we are able to meet standard, international standard of production. Okay, now main feature of new economic policy, means new economic policy, whenever we talk about NEP, NEP is equal to what? LPG. Remember this, NEP means what? It is equal to LPG, yani it refers to LPG, liberalization, privatization and globalization. Okay, so NEP means these two. Okay, so here is written, the government initiated a variety of policy which fall under the three heads. Okay, whenever any government follow liberalization and privatization, so its result is
globalization. Globalization is not a system or any reform. It is result of liberalization and privatization. If any economy, it is going to be liberal. Anyone who wants to establish offer, he is allowed. Yes, he is allowed. Okay, they don't have to do a lot of paperwork. So obviously, there will be more entrepreneur, there will be more business houses, there will be more production in the economy. Okay, and privatization is related to that. Liberal means when we are going to give freedom. Liberal means freedom. So when there is freedom, there will be growth of privatization. Okay, and when there will be liberalization and privatization, so obviously economy become global. How? Because there will be no restrictions, there is total freedom, 100% freedom. So anyone can come within the India, they can establish their company, they can purchase share and bonds. So in this way, it become a global economy. Okay, so out of liberalization and privatization and globalization, the first two are policy strategy, and third one is the outcome of these three strategy. So it is again important. It can be asked question ki what is the result of liberalization and privatization. So what is result? Globalization. Okay, now liberalization, privatization and globalization is also known as a LPG. Okay, so I think now you are understand what is the meaning of NEP. NEP, yani economic policy, means it is related to many reforms. It is related to many reforms. Okay, and within this we are going to learn about three things: liberalization, globalization and privatization. Okay, so what is liberalization? Before the 1991, okay, after 200 years, we are able to gain the freedom. Okay, there is our own government of India. Okay, that is elected by Indian people. So obviously we don't going to have any faith outsiders. So because of that, we follow such type of policy that our economy become a closed economy. And that is why our first aim is that we want to get self-dependent. We are able to produce all type of goods and services that Indian people require. तो अब हमारी जो सोच थी वो बहुत अच्छी थी. हम चाहते थे सेल्फ डिपेंडेंट बनना, सारी कमोडिटीज़ को खुद प्रोड्यूस करना, लेकिन ऐसा हो नहीं पाया. इनिशियली वी गेट पॉजिटिव रिजल्ट. देयर इज़ इंक्रीज इन पर कैपिटा इनकम, देयर इज़ इंक्रीज इन जीडीपी. ओके, एंड देयर इज़ डाइवर्सिफिकेशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज. बट अल्टीमेटली बिकॉज वी डोंट थिंक अबाउट सेलिंग द गुड्स, we just think that ki we will produce and we will consume it. So we don't think about export, and because of don't thinking about export, we are not going to sell too much product, but we are importing capital goods, we are importing machine equipment. For purchasing these we require foreign currency, and you cannot print it. How you are able to get foreign currency? When you are going to sell your product. So in return, what you get foreign currency. Okay, if suppose America is going to purchase 10 cooler, so that trader is going to give you price in dollar. They are going to pay dollar, and in this way you are able to get the dollar. Now you can purchase from that dollar anything from America. So this is the trade. Okay, but before 1991 we are following import substitution, not export promotion. Result is that key we are not having foreign currency reserves. Okay, and our balance of payment become unfavorable. So ultimately we require $7 billion as a loan. Okay, so this loan is given on this condition you have to follow LPG. Now we are going to learn the meaning of liberalization. What is the meaning of liberalization? So liberalization means removal of entry growth restriction of the private sector. So before the 1991 we are following the policy of import substitution. So for import substitution we follow two tools, that is quota and tariff. Quota means we are going to fix the amount how many unit a foreigner can sell in India. Okay, so this is quota. Okay, fixing the amount of goods. And tariff means tax, import tax. So with the help of high import tax and fixing the amount, there is protection for Indian industry. Okay, but now when we gain this loan, now we are going to shift from license, permit, quota to LPG. So what is the what was the condition? Now we have to remove all type of import duty, yeah, tax and quota. There after 1991 there is no quota, no high taxes, import taxes. Okay, so this is the meaning, underline it and you are going to learn. What is the liberalization? Removal of entry and growth restriction on private sector. So what it involve? It involve reduction of government control and greater authority, yeah, freedom for private investment. Okay, now private sector is able to open up their firm. There is not any type of restriction. Anyone can come and they can set up their industry. Okay, under this process, business is given free hand and it is allowed to run commercialized firms. Okay, now there is no restrictions. So that's why they are free to open up their industry. What was the purpose or aim? So that we are going to discuss. First is to improve economic potential. Means with the help of NEP, yeah, with the help of liberalization, we want that ki there will be more foreign currency, there will be more foreign firm will come in India, they will invest in India and there will be more production of goods and services. Second, competition. Now government want that there will be high competition. Every firm, yeah, every business house will try to produce goods more and more at a low price, and also they will try to meet the international standard. So because for this they had opened up this economy. Now in this liberalization we are going to discuss these reform: industrial sector reform, financial sector reform, tax reform, foreign exchange reforms and trade and investment policy reform. But not in this video, in the next video. Okay, so for today it is this much. Tomorrow we are going to, yeah, next video we are going to discuss these reform that take place for removal all type of barriers and to giving total freedom, 100% freedom to private sector. Okay student, I think you are able to understand. In this video we actually learned two basic thing: NEP, so what is the meaning of NEP, when it was launched, what is its aim, and measures. So there are stabilizing measures and structural change measures. After that we had just learned about the meaning of liberalization. What is liberalization? Removal of all type of barriers and giving 100% freedom to private sector. Why we had done? So that there will be increase in our potential for production of goods and services and there will be high competition. Okay, thank you student.